a 22-year-old guy called into one of my live shows, and he asked me for advice on what type of career, how does he find the right career for him? And what I told him was, look for something that you're interested in, that you are passionate about, and then see if you can monetize that. And I sort of want to give a little bit more of a thorough explanation as to how I think a young person should look for a career. I'm going to use my own mistakes as a guide as well. When I say monetize it, I mean something that will pay you enough where you can live a comfortable life. I don't mean the liberal arts, $30,000 a year income with $40,000 in debt. I can't afford health insurance type of gig, that type of career. No. I'm talking about something where, you know, you're starting off with more like 45 or 50, something where you're starting off at a really good point. Okay. Not something where, at least where you can get to 50,000 pretty quickly within 3 years or so. Like, for example, in the trades, certain trades like an electrician, you can get to that very quickly and make more than that. You know, plumbers, you know, people, bricklayers, they can get to that pretty quickly. They start off as a journeyman. They start off as apprentices, and then they work their way up to become a journeyman, and they become a master plumber, electrician, or whatever. And they can do that and go to community college and get some knowledge, some classes that way. Without going broke. Okay, that liberal arts stuff, I say, another way you can look at it is this: find something that the world needs, and when I say need, I mean something that the world's willing to pay you for. Okay, I don't care how much of a need there is for a certain field. If they're not going to pay you, then it doesn't really mean anything. I'm speaking as a person who, you know, I took 2 years of AutoCAD or computer aided drafting in high school. And I was actually kind of good at doing the blueprints and stuff like that, but I didn't have the math skills. I didn't have the necessary math skills really to help me in engineering once I got to college. Matter of fact, I struggled even basically reading even in college, so I needed to go to college. There's some basic basic knowledge and learning skills that I needed. I mean, I struggled throughout school. Throughout grade school, but that's a whole other issue. I would go at 22. Hopefully, you would have already invested enough time in beefing up your math skills. If you're 13, 14, you're watching this video, focus on math. Do not sit around and wait on the school to educate you in mathematics. You need, just like you take time to play video games 3 hours a day, at least take 1 hour a day to work, beef up your math skills. I don't care if you gotta work with an older brother or somebody else. Some club at school, get a tutor. I don't care what you got to do. I don't care if your mother or father, anybody has any math skills, take advantage of that. Or talk to an uncle. Be really aggressive in developing math skills, at least, so you have some options. You want to go into STEM, some type of science, some type of technology, something like that, medicine, medical, anything like that, engineering, stuff like that. That's something you want to focus on, something that the world is willing to actually pay you for. If you just passionate about it and you can't monetize it, you can't get money for it, that's not gonna work. Okay, it's not all about, oh, well, what makes me happy. That could be a really important part. If you can find something that makes you happy and you get paid for it, great. But you want to, first and foremost, you want to have some options. You want to have something that'll pay you, because I started off with computer science as a major, but I didn't have the math background, and I made a mistake in going into something else that I was interested in, but it would be a little bit easier, and that was a big mistake. I went into criminal justice. I was genuinely interested in criminal justice, but looking back, I should have probably just stuck with computer science. I should have been more aggressive in going after that, although who knows, the way IT is gone in certain areas, a lot of those jobs gone overseas to China. But anyway, that's beside the point. Think of something the world absolutely needs. And need, I mean, they're willing to pay for it. Not people saying, oh, we can really use sociologists. Hey, look, if you want to become a PhD, major in sociology and all that stuff, good for you. But understand that you got to calculate the debt you're going to require to get in all that stuff. And for me, I just think the trades are better for a lot of people. So that's something you should definitely consider. Just be pragmatic. Don't just think paycheck to paycheck. Think about something where you can actually support yourself and a family. You may not want a family now, but you gotta ask yourself, okay, if I go into this field at year 5, am I gonna be able to support myself and a couple of kids? That's an important question to ask. Because some of these fields, especially in the social sciences, unless you have a PhD or something, even if you have a master's, a lot of stuff is sort of designed for women who marry engineers or somebody like that, or entrepreneurs or something like that. You can have that type of job because they don't pay enough for you to really support yourself and the whole family. But I don't mean to knock the entire field or anything. I'm just saying STEM, trade schools, measure out the pros and cons. This is something I say to people a lot, okay, when you're faced with a major decision. Because a lot of times you let emotion just drive you in a certain direction. And it really counteract that. Good thing to do is get a sheet of paper, a pen, write down all the pros, be really honest, and all the cons, okay? The advantages and disadvantages, and just put it down on paper. Because you can have this stuff floating in your head, but you can be focusing on that one pro in your head. And in your head, you're ignoring the 7 or 8 cons, okay? But if you put it down on paper, it sort of forces you to look at it. So that's the advice I would have for you. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Guys, share your thoughts on the type of career, how a 20-something should pick out his career. Once again, thank you for watching. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.